Good morning and good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for joining in for this session, and it feels great to be part of Testflix and the novel Atomic Talks. Thank you so much, Mahesh, and the entire Testripe team for giving me an opportunity to share my thoughts and an opportunity to learn from distinguished speakers from across the globe. When someone asks you, what are your skills? What's your natural response? What do we write in our CVs? Are we able to differentiate between the languages, techniques, and skills? And in case we are unable to confidently answer, internally deep within, it's a sinking feeling, probably a feeling of, I don't know anything. Many inadvertently end up saying, I'm a manual tester. Well, it's not your fault alone. If we as leaders are guilty of largely creating this shallow ecosystem, we as testers are equally guilty of not focusing on building a strong foundation and working skillfully. I'm sorry if it makes us feel bad. However, that's a hard-hitting fact. But all is not lost yet. It's heartening to witness green pastures as well. The Testripe community, like many other that exist out there globally, are the green pastures and continue to be torchbearers of some amazing work. There are some very outstanding people presenting in this conference whose body of work has been instrumental in keeping the craft alive. Yes, testing indeed is a craft. As testers, it is our responsibility to not only understand, learn, master, respect the craft, but also spread and share the nuances of this craft. Skills and knowledge need to be passed on. At the same time, the key is celebrating the craftsmanship. If we have chosen this profession, whether accidentally or by choice, it is important to know and understand the depths of it. All of us understand the difference between job and career. Career is aligned with the core values, is long-term, leads to professional growth. The word craft comes from the Middle English and has German origins. And it means strength. It means skill in planning, making, and executing. To be good in any profession, one needs to have a very good balance of the four pillars. We all know that knowledge is power, and with power comes responsibility. But at the same time, knowledge is useless without consistent application. Tools are the ways to perform a task differently and efficiently. We as an industry are fascinated with tools. There is nothing wrong in it, as tools bring in efficiencies. The only thing we need to guard against is blindly relying on tools without understanding two aspects: how the tool is going to help us solve the problem, which tool to use, where and when. The next one is techniques. Techniques are a specific method of doing an activity, usually a method that involves application of knowledge, tools, and different skills. That brings us to skills. Unfortunately, one aspect that we often neglect is skills. While to some extent we might be good at technical skills, and it creates an illusion that makes us falsely believe we are good at our craft. Through this medium, I would like to humbly request all testers across the globe, be it the ones who have recently started their journey or ones who are experienced enough to understand what it takes to be a good tester. We all want a fit body. If you are into exercising, we often hear about core exercises. Any exercise that involves the use of our abdominal and back muscles in a coordinated fashion counts as a core exercise. Weak core muscles can leave us susceptible to poor posture, lower back pain, and muscle injuries. Core exercises improve your balance and stability. Core exercises don't require specialized equipment or a gym membership. The ask is very simple: strengthen the core. A healthy body, a healthy mind. However, we are often plagued with doubt and self-limiting mindset. Extending to the point of tools we touched upon earlier, we have the best one within. Scientists used to think that brain development only occurred during our childhood and then stopped. In other words, it was believed that our initial brain development in our early years, our brains became fixed and hardwired. It was believed that once our brains developed, they could not be changed or reorganized. However, the research studies show a different picture. We rewire our brains to adapt to new circumstances. This happens on a daily basis, but it's also something that we can encourage and stimulate. Most brain activity seems to be due to a very special class of cells called neurons. In his book, The Joy of Living, Mingyu Rinpoche, a Tibetan monk who has been a subject of latest medical experiments, explains that neurons are very special cells. They love to gossip. In some ways, they are like naughty school children, constantly chatting, whispering, passing notes, except this secret conversation between neurons, is about sensations, movements, solving problems, creating memories, and creating thoughts and emotions. When neurons connect like this, they form a strong bond, very much like old friendships. They get into a habit of passing the same sort of messages back and forth. The way old friends tend to reinforce each other's judgments about people, events, and experiences. This bonding is the biological basis of what we call mental habits. Repeated experiences can change the way the brain works. The capacity to replace old neuronal connections with new ones is often referred as neuroplasticity, which is the ability of neural networks in the brain to change through growth and reorganization. Is it all sounding very confusing? Well, confusion is all we know is the beginning of understanding. That brings us to one of the two skills that I would like to emphasize on. The first one is questioning skills. The use of questioning skills is essential to systematic investigation in any subject area. Asking questions is easy. It is important to understand. The ability to ask effective questions requires skills. It requires practice. It requires clarity and thought. Ask questions to understand and know about concepts. Build the ability to ask pertinent questions. Ability to ask questions that help you to discover more about your feature, application, product under test. Ability to ask technically pertinent questions. Ability to ask leading questions. Ability to ask probing questions. Good questions are purposeful, thought-provoking. But there are two questions that are the most undervalued in general, and I often find in software testing as well. So which are these two most important questions that will open the world for you? These two questions are what if and why not. Why are they valuable for testers? They're important because they challenge the assumptions and open endless possibilities. They generate alternatives. They open numerous doors and windows for you. These questions are powerful and can open things up when you get stuck as well. We claim ourselves to be an intelligent race. As testers, we often undervalue and neglect building our thinking skills, one that we need to not only have in our arsenal, but got to be excellent at it. In this fast-changing world, dynamic world, it is imperative we not only develop the ability to learn, adapt, but it is extremely important to look beyond the default, which means it is important to develop and hone our thinking skills. Within thinking skills, the one where we as testers really need to sharpen the axe is lateral thinking. Lateral thinking, a term first coined by Edward de Bono in 1967, refers to a person's capacity to address problems by imagining solutions that can be arrived at via deductive or logical means. Or to put in simpler terms, the ability to develop original answers to difficult questions. This is the essence of creativity, and all organizations benefit from it at times of change, when by definition, traditional solutions are unlikely to get the desired result. There are two aspects to it. Vertical thinking and lateral thinking. Vertical thinking is the conventional thinking, logical, critical, and analytical thinking, long supported by traditional education. Vertical thinking is focused on what is. De Bono says this will not yield creative solutions. Vertical thinking at times is also referred as adversarial thinking, where people are more focused on getting around arguments, defeating others' argument, than actually solving the problem itself. Whereas on the other hand, lateral thinking, simply put, is unconventional thinking. We often call lateral thinking as outside the box thinking. Does that sound familiar? Out of box test scenarios? Well, we have been hearing it from the very first interview. But did we pay enough attention to master this thinking skill? How much have we invested in thinking skills and specifically lateral thinking? The difference between the vertical thinking and the lateral thinking are very fundamental. The processes are distinct. It is not a matter of one is effective than the other. It is a matter of realizing the differences in order to be able to use both effectively. The ability to problem solve and think critically is one of the main attributes that we would be evaluated on as we continue our digital journey. For we human testers, our thinking skills would be the one of the key differentiators in this journey, and we need to put together a clear action plan and develop the lateral thinking. With that, thank you so much. Have a great day and learning experience.